I'm John Dylan Haynes. I'm a brain researcher, and I try to read people's minds by looking at their brain activity. What's so interesting about the brain is that it's such a complex mechanism, and we've seen some very exciting developments in the last few years because new imaging technology allows us such insights into human brain activity. Brain scanners can monitor the brain at work. This is how it works. Every thought that someone has is linked to a unique pattern of brain activity. That means that if you think about an orchestral sound, for example, then a certain pattern of activity is triggered. If you think of a Picasso painting, then a different pattern of activity is triggered. You can predict what people will think before the people even know it themselves. We've conducted brain scans on subjects, for example, and gave them a button to push in their left hand and another in their right hand. And you could detect a pattern of brain activity 7 seconds before a decision was made. One big area of application that has been talked about a lot is how far brain activity can be read for police and legal investigations. A lot of the debate has been about how far it should go. We can look directly in the brain when a person is lying, creating a perfect lie detector. We can't do that yet today, though. One important area of research is brain-computer interfaces, machines that translate between brain activity and any technical application, such as using thoughts to control a video game. Another important area is medical applications, of course. Prostheses, for example. When nerves are no longer available, they could possibly be operated through thoughts.
Möchte man vielleicht einfach mit Gedankenkraft diese steuern?
Or if you're paralyzed, it could be used for these people to be able to communicate with the outside world. You think of a letter and it would directly read out that letter. There's an entire range of industrial applications which we're researching here in Berlin. Sleep warning systems, for example. For the auto industry, that could mean a device that measures brain activity to determine whether a person is falling asleep at the wheel.
Und sie lesen dann aus dieser Hirnaktivität, ob eine Person müde wird oder nicht.
Definitely another 10 to 20 years more research is needed. We can't really carry around these kind of brain scanners. They weigh 15 tons and they're not very practical. A measuring device that fits under a cap is what I would like to see.